Today's telecast is presented live from Green Bay, Wisconsin, at the historic football shrine, Slambone Field, where so much of mutant football's history has been written in blood. Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. The Philadelphia Eagles go up against the Green Bay Attackers. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's time to tune in, turn on, and drop what you're doing, because NFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. So what's the game plan for the home team today, Bricks?
I think they gotta keep it simple. A little cough syrup, maybe smoke a little untidy pod pregame so they can keep their heads in the game. I mean, literally. You don't want to get decapitated on the opening kickoff.
I say go after the refs early and often. No mercy.
Quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. Run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the change of score, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. Caught for the first down. And it's first and 10. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. First and 10. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. Third down and, well, good luck. Nice pass for a 10-yard gain.
It's not a first down in the stat line, but it's a first down in our hearts.
Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he's got a chance for a good one. Oh, mama, he just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10. Come on, man, you gotta catch that.
I don't catch anything, Rim. I'm retired.
Second down and 10. Looks like they're just going to pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
I'm not going to touch that one.
That's what she said.
And it's first and 10. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. First and 10. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? Second down and 5. First down and 3. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
This is your brain, and this is your brain on berserker drugs. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Third down and 3. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Thank you. hard bricks?
Yep, third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckle.
Second down in a mile. That's a 4-yard gain. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. You know the defense wants some payback after that. Well, this kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco.
Does anyone have a rule book? Because that sounds like he's making stuff up.
Do we have a rule book?
It's propping up your chair so you can reach the table without spilling your food, idiot.
Ballsy, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he snags the punt and looks for open field. Oh, he just got crushed. And it's first and 10. It was a risky throw, and the defense made him pay.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10. You can tell he's dead. This guy just blew up, and he's at no doubt about it. That guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. He's at the 40. The 30. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And that's just a great run for a touchdown. Defense called a time warp dirty trick, negating that play completely. The offense is pissed.
Well, I wish I had that trick in the elevator with me earlier. I let one rip. I mean, a really good one rip. And then the doors open and the team's cheerleaders get on. Oh, that's when small talk is really put to the test.
And that'll be second down and 4.
Oh my gosh! The defensive player looks like he's lost his mind!
Now that's just the berserker rage kicking in. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Oh, with the brain scrambler. Second down and 5. Hey, kids, do you remember getting shoved in a locker because you wore glasses? I do. So he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Third down and 5. Deflected the ball. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. How do you like your defenses cooked? The ball carrier is saying, well done.
Bang, baby, bang.
And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
And it's first and 10. And it's 2 minutes left in the half.
I can't wait till the halftime show.
And it's first and 10. And the running game is starting to click now. A pickup of 8 on the play. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with 2 in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
Third down and 5.
When I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedic.
Hey, timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You gotta use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
First down and 9. Put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. Oh, with the punishing hit. Second down and six. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Third down and six. Quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. Thank God he's still got his leg. He's going to need all of it for this kick.
Hey, a Sawbuck says he misses.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And it's first and ten. And he held on to that one for a first down. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsatan Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? Huh? We're going to go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit.
Touch me with eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Chains, that's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and ten. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and ten.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
He runs it for three. Second and one. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. And that'll bring up third and one.
accident ride, but he drove out of the field in a brand new hearse.
Third down and long.
And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Third down and forever. Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. And it's first and ten. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down. And this ref is definitely on the take. That was a bogus penalty. They're back up here on first. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and a mile. Left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
And that is caught for a first down. And it's first and ten. And the ball is left. And that's a run for no gain. Second down and ten. And that's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'm itching like crazy over here.
Third down, and the punter is warming up. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and ten. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
He's at, and they're catching up.
Joke, jump, do something.
The 20. And he runs out of gas and got tackled short of the goal line. Hell of a run, though.
I'd like to stand in half a to a lot of guys, Grim. At least that's what I hear.
And it's first and 10. And this guy is on fuego. Does he like his original or extra crispy? By the looks of it, extra crispy. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Looks like he does have some turkey skin grafted on his backside from that bad burn he had last year.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chick wearing a wig.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and 10. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second down and 6. And then Cats will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
Second down and 10. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Third down, and, well, good luck.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And he snags it for 6! Touchdown! Touchdown! Well, why go for 1 when you could go for 2?
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get 1. Oh.
And he gets into the end zone for the conversion. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and 10. Second down and long. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And he just wrestles away from that side.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10.
Love the sound of bones snapping and cracking. I mean, when they're not yawn.
Second and 3. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10. The defensive players go berserk. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? Because I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
Second down in a very lot. Third down and long. Oh, he just cremated that guy. And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Second down and 10. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Third down and 6. Oh, great play! He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
Oh, man, the offense called a murder ball.
That's a little on the nose, don't you think? That's sort of...
And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Two minutes left in the game. Hang on. And it's first and 10. He caught it, and nothing. was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
The defense erases the previous play by transporting the offense back in time.
I heard that Time Warp Dirty Trick uses advanced alien black hole technology.
Yeah, your entire life is one big black hole.
And they run it for a couple of yards. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy!
And into the end zone for a touchdown! Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races! Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It's good. The onside kick's a desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal a possession.
Still, it ain't right, Grim. It just ain't right.
It's 1st and 10. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see.
The defense has to make something happen here with 1 timeout left. Second down and 5. And he picks up 2 yards on the catch. And defense calls its final timeout.
Good. I gotta run to the John. That means I gotta deal with that grubby little bathroom attendant again. Always pushing his lifesavers, dirty comb, hairspray, cheap cologne on me. Hey, I'm here to take a crap. Now get ready for a date.
Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's 1st and 10. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. Remember, folks, in the NFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And he catches it for 6 yards. Good mitts on that play, Bricks. His fingers are like a bunch of sausages. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. Any field goals over 40 yards are difficult. He's going to really have to boom this one. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just get the points and let's move on.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's 1st and 10. Right rage ignites that deep down violent rage and makes you unstoppable. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. The 10. He did it. He scores. And with that amazing run, he bursts through the end zone for 6.
Yeah.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Put that one in the loss column. The Grim Bay Attackers lose the game.
And they lost me $50.
The opposition came into town and stole one from them. It's a bitter one-point loss.
Just like a thief in the night. They should go to jail. Stealing ain't right, Grim.
Let's listen to what the game's most valuable player has to say about it.
Why? The guy's got the intelligence of a horseshoe.
With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.